Once again, our nation is mourning Australians killed overseas, an entire police force joining families in their grief.
It is a shock for us, and it will take quite some time for us all to come to terms with this.
Six Australians dead, five from Victoria, including two serving police officers. Senior Constable Christy Olsen had a 10-year-old son. He's now struggling to comprehend that she'll never come home.
As well as any 10-year-old whose whole world's fallen out from underneath him. So, he's with family.
At Mowi in the state's southeast, her family was comforted by others.
Just numb. I just thought, couldn't that be Christy? He's too young.
The 34-year-old had long planned her Egyptian adventure.
I suppose the saddest thing was it's the first time she'd ever been overseas. And for this to happen 4 days in is just absolutely tragic.
Sergeant George Paniotis was a 20-year veteran in the police radio and electronics unit. The 48-year-old's wife was with him. She's in a critical condition.
The thoughts and prayers of George's family are with those in hospital in Egypt today and to the other families who have lost loved ones.
A father and son from Bendigo, invited on the tour by police friends, were also killed. Two others who died haven't been named. One is from Melbourne, one from Queensland. 26 Aussies were injured, 15 are Victorians.
I send on behalf of the government, for myself and my colleagues, our heartfelt sympathies to those who've lost loved ones.
The annual tour is popular with police, their families and friends. The bus crashed as the group returned to Cairo after visiting the El Alamein battlefield near Alexandria. Australian diplomats are in Cairo. A police commander due there late today.
It's just such a broad range of injuries and death to come to terms with at once.
Jeremy Pudney, 10 News.